Greetings everyone, and welcome back to the Shed of Endless Possibility. Or perhaps it should be the Shed of Endless Doom. Right. It's poetry time again, folks. To all the family members and subscribers, as always, thank you for being here. I appreciate you all. Thank you so much for the comments. They make everything worthwhile. Right, the first poem I shall read is called Zachary. I come from many places. I have travelled many lands, seeking out the night creatures with the power of death in hand. I am a hunter of those dark monsters who create the living dead, those creatures who hunt in the darkness and in daylight in earthen bed. They are creating an army of servants. Their master is feared by the undead, those who sup from throbbing veins, blood so deep, so dark, so red. I too became one of those creatures, but I never lost my human heart. I am of all creatures the most lonely, just a sad victim from the start. My master was a guile-filled man who seduced me in his bed, then drank of my precious life force, biting the neck below my head. Cursed to hunt on the streets at night, never again to see the rising sun. How I wish I could turn back the clock. What I know now would have made me run. I sought out this obscene creator. I took his life so he could take no more. I became a slayer of vampires. In the cloak of darkness I wore. I will go on in my quest to slay them, until I am left standing the only one. Then I will surrender into the daylight, and on that day my work is done. Right, folks, where do we go next? The next poem, which I would like to read, is called Heretic. The heretic dares to have his own beliefs. How dare he argue with his peers? To be caught is sure and certain death. It is not only God he must fear. To hold on to beliefs not taught in the church, his life hangs by a single thread. If he dares to practice his own beliefs, very soon he will be dead. He is betrayed by another's kiss. They move him to carry him away. He must be now tried and sentenced. For him, this is judgment day. Found guilty of disobeying the faith, he'll be tied to a stake and burn. Let this be something you heed. It's a lesson you don't want to learn. He could no longer speak out his heresies. A spike had been driven through his tongue, so he could not be spreading his learning and influencing those who were young. He was tied to the stake and wood piled around until he was almost hidden from view. A flaming torch was held to the wood. The inquisitor knew what to do. There was an almighty crackling. The fire burned with a fierce glow. The heretic began to scream and shout as his torment began to grow. Mumbled shrieks came from his torn mouth. His eyeballs both popped out. A hiss and a crackle as his flesh burned. The assembled mob began to shout. The bloody pulp beneath the skin began to melt and burst into flame. There was a terrible smell of charred flesh. and the heretic was in great pain. There was much jubilation and cheering when the heretic finally burned away, the poor man at such a horrifying death on that terrible and fateful day. His crime, it was discovered later, was disagreeing with the Pope. People should be allowed to think for themselves if the world is to have any hope. Right, folks, the last one I would like to read is called The Crone. Venomous droplets fall from poisoned lips. Scent of poison heavy upon her breath. Destructive words flow from pen in fingertips. Gnarled fingers tap as she plots your death. Her cold dark eyes flash with evil intent. Incantations uttered sent spells that kill. The black candle flame is glowing bright. A tingle to your spine, icy cold, her will. Her black cloak flaps in the cold night air. Ink of bloody red from the nib does spill. In Theban script unknown, that secret text, she writes with purpose, with feathered quill. The parchment paper soaks up the ink, a spell to bring about your demise. Chanting the words with an evil heart, malice there in her dark, cold eyes. Words so powerful once spoken aloud, image of the victim in her scrying bowl. A spell once cast cannot be retrieved, words that bring destruction to your soul. Beware next time you cross the witch, unaware of the power you know nothing about. You may just have become a victim of the witch. Once a spell is cast, there is no doubt. Educated and clever you may think you are, but spells from aeons of time now spoken, nowhere to run, nowhere to hide, dark magic has been awoken. All you can do is await your final breath. The chiming of the clock ticks away your fate, begging for forgiveness for whatever you did. No forgiveness to be found, because it is too late. Right, everyone, I hope you've enjoyed what you've heard. If you have, please leave a comment in the box. Hit the bell icon for any future uploads. Hit the like button if you're able. And if you're not yet subscribed, please consider doing so. Won't cost you a penny. Helps the channel grow. And will become part of that bigger community. As always, I will say to you all, Namaste. Enjoy the rest of Thursday, everyone. Bye for now.
The time has come.
He's back. My little friend. There we go, folks. Better do as I'm told and run. There he is.
Let me out.
Trapped inside the mirror.
The time has come.
Here, all on Halloween. Thanks again for listening, everyone. Bye for now.